Hi, my name is Okibo Nemeka Prince Will.
You can understand. The life is very short. Whatever you get to do in life, they don't must. We say life is contained of good and bad, but we can't help it, lots of us. You can understand.
The conversation we're about to have is going to be a very sensitive one. I understand the sensitivity, and it has to do with your brother who died 1 year ago. I also understand that you are undergoing the healing process after his demise, and I'm also sure that this is the first time you publicly say something about him since he died. You know, one of the ways to immortalize your brother, to celebrate your brother, is to actually talk about him, some of the things he stands for, his philosophies, his way of life, his belief system. Entirely. So in the healing process, we cannot entirely ignore talking about him. So that is why we have you today. And I want to begin by asking, who is Prince Will Okibo to you?
Well, Prince Will Nemeka Okibo is my elder brother, my paternal name. He is the second child of the family. Okibo Nemeka. I grew up to know him as another brother. I didn't grow up with him. He grew up at Anambra with my aunt. When I was small, I used to see him as a cousin.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I used to see him as a cousin because he was only living with us. He always come back during occasions, maybe Christmas or Easter, with my aunt and my cousin.
Yeah.
So for me, he's just my cousin. So, on one Christmas, that should be, I can't remember the year now, they came back and he refused to go back with them. Then, that was when he started staying at home with us. So, he was enrolled into Northern Primary School. That was my primary school.
Okay. So, he was little then?
He wasn't that little. Maybe around 10.
Oh, 10.
He was enrolled into Northern Primary School. He started primary 5. After primary 5, primary 6, then he took entrance examination for seminary. At some time, minor seminary, he passed.
Oh, wow.
Wow. Thanks be to God for that.
Yeah, sure.
After he studied from JS1 to JS3 at some time, minor seminary, Nazi. Then he would come back teaching us Oremus Pro Sante Communion.
Oh, really?
Yes. Ave Maria.
Gracia
Plena. Plena. You should know better. Then telling us about a seminarian who took money from his parents on the note that he broke the seminary Oremus. Seminary Oremus. Well, Oremus in Latin, okay, Latin, Oremus is a Latin word for prayer.
Oh,
so,
really?
Yes, you can't just go and take money from your parents telling them you broke the seminary Oremus. You can't break prayer.
Oh, the student goes to say that he has broken the seminary prayer.
Imagine.
Okay, knowing quite well that the parents,
they don't know anything about
Latin expression.
Yes.
Okay.
Then, okay, when he entered JS2 or JS3, he was given the chief sacristan.
Yeah.
At the time, he fell sick. He was asthmatic then, fell sick. The rector then, Reverend Father Emmanuel Oparugo, brought him home and insisted that he shouldn't continue.
Oh, really?
Yes. That should be when he was in JSS3. So, after his treatment, my father took him back and begged. Rector accepted him back. and told him that he can't continue working as a chief sacristan. It was like then all for wisdom.
Oh, wisdom.
Wisdom from Avo. He intervened and he was retained in the sacristy as the chief sacristan. Then I can remember one time I asked my mom about my name. Okay, he told me Nnemeka named me Chinonso after I was giving birth to.
Okay, Nnemeka gave you your Igbo name.
That wasn't my Igbo name, but everybody calls me Chinonso.
Okay.
Chibuike is what is written in my baptismal.
The official.
Yeah, my official Igbo name. Okay. But everybody calls me Chinonso. Nobody calls me Chibuike.
Okay. Right now.
Right now.
So he had influence in your name.
Yes. Not only that, he himself, he doesn't call me Chinonso.
Okay.
He calls me Stebe.
What does that mean?
My name is Beke, but
Beke.
Okay, he calls me Skebe.
Why?
I don't know.
They change.
Yes, he calls me Skebe or Kebe or whichever one. Well, not come like that. I've never complained about that.
You don't have to complain.
I don't have to complain.
When Prince Nnemeka Okigbo died in 2018, you wrote a very thought-provoking tribute for him, a very revealing write-up. So we would want you to repeat some of the things you wrote. But before then, we'd like to know, who are you and who is Okigbo Prince Nnemeka to you?
My name is Mbagwa Marate Chulaka, and Prince Will Okigbo Nnemeka was a friend and a brother to me before he died.
How did you feel when you got the news of Nnemeka's death?
Okay, how I felt when I got the news of Nnemeka's death. Before I can tell how I felt, I would love to talk about how I got to know about Nnemeka's sickness. Alright, I got to know about Nnemeka's sickness on April 1st, 2018 when we went for Project 300, and I was hoping to meet Nnemeka there. But on getting there, I didn't see Nnemeka, so I asked of him. It was Robinson Okuri, I asked, and Robinson told me Nnemeka was in the hospital. So I left the venue for the Project 300 and then went to see him in the hospital. So that was how I got to know about his sickness.
I want you to briefly tell us about yourself, and then who is Okigbo Prince Nnemeka to you?
I'm Chukwuemeka Nwachukwu, a graduate of accounting in Imo State University. Okigbo Prince Nnemeka was my classmate while we were in the minor seminary. Sometime minor seminary as far back as 2007, where we started our young journey. We actually wanted to be priests. That was the concept then. From sometime minor seminary, we moved down to St. Peter Clever Seminary of Ala, where we had our SS 1, 2, and 3. But I left at my SS 2. But my relationship with Nnemeka, he was actually my corner mate at St. Mark's Hostel. Actually know that being a corner mate, the pits one who actually know your private life, or actually have a shared life with your next bunk mate. Nnemeka was actually like a brother to me, a friend, and he was a companion really. So we had a lot in common. We actually made out for each other. We actually made sure that both of us weren't lacking. We actually made sure that I had water to take my bed, and I did the same for him. So Nnemeka actually leaving this world was a painful thing for me, really, and it really touched me, and I never had it easy within that period, even up until now. Being here actually now, talking about him, trying to recount his life, is never an easy feat, but we actually want to do the best for him, create a legacy and have something to hold on to, that we actually did it for him. And wherever he is, he might be happy, he will be happy knowing that there are people out there who are trying to sing his song, who are trying to live his holistic life, a life that is full of appraisal, good ones, a life that will actually look back and say, this guy actually had a lot for this world. But we can't question God, and we just have to move on and pray that he's resting in the bosom of the Lord.
Is there something you wish you would have told him if he was still alive today?
Yes, something I wish I could have told him. Probably right now, I'm a graduate at Bedeco. I think I found myself in a better place in life to give a better disposition about what we should have done then and now. So even Emeka were to be alive, if he was alive or is that on his dying bed, I would have told him. Because I never had the chance to visit him. He still bears me and he asked for forgiveness for that, and I could have told him to just hang on. Let's just try to accomplish one out of several goals we had, one out of several aspirations we wanted to acquire and everything. I didn't have the opportunity, and I wanted to just tell him, okay, just give me a hack of how you do pull up the stunts, how you do try to associate everybody, because being social is not just a quality everybody has. I could be anti-social to some extent. I could try to shut up social life. I could try to hold on to all of my personal or private moments. When Emeka actually has a hack of him doing everything and also having his personal life, but actually asking how do you pull off this stunt, how do you do this and all that. But I thought maybe just for one moment, let me feel that aura you possess in life. I think it's very difficult, and past life you can't face on it. Lost Emeka, we lost a rare gem, and we lost someone who could have seen right now.
So after we got back from the hospital, we were planning to visit Okibo in Emeka Prince's world on Thursday. That was June 8th, 2018. We were planning to visit Okibo in the hospital again. But then on Tuesday, 5th June 2018, I got home to receive a WhatsApp message from Robin saying that Okibo was dead.
Do you have anything to say about the spiritual life?
The spiritual life, personally, I won't try to delve into that because I don't really pay attention to people's personal life. Why you say that? He was a sacristan.
Yeah.
So, Emeka, as a sacristan, Emeka was so up to date with the church ethics and whatever happened in the church. And everything, and the sacristan, he woke me up on time before the rising bell, so he made sure I was up to date. I think he was actually my guide and my timekeeper then, despite us having a regulator. When the mechanic made sure I was actually up to date, and most times he brings the liturgical books across, he will say some prayers by the bedside and everything. I think ever since I left the seminary, I've not been more spiritual than I was with him.
Yeah.
Because he kept that spiritual life afloat. He made that spiritual life. He ignited that passion for me to actually focus on spiritual life. So despite leaving the seminary, he told me, okay, while I'm in the seminary, I should just try to hold on to the Catholic doctrines and the ethics which I learned from seminary, and also try to hold on to any of these priorities in my parish or whatsoever.
Are you aware that when your brother was alive, he was reaching out to people?
One thing I know about him, he's always visiting the old people. Then, there is this one insane man in my place, they call him Skin Palais.
Oh,
Skin Palais. So, he's always visiting the man, discussing with him. Then, on one occasion, I asked him, he said, that man is very, very intelligent.
Oh, really?
I said, how? He said, that man is very, very intelligent. He said, but people, what will people think seeing you sitting together with Skin Palais? He said that's not his problem.
Yeah.
That he wants to get something from Skin Palais.
There's something you wish you would have told Okibo before he died.
Yeah, something I wish I had told Okibo before he died. Yes. All my life I've never had a hard time telling people how much I love him until it got to Okibo. So one thing I regret not telling Okibo before he died was how much I love him.
Yeah.
And then after Okibo's death, a particular song now reminds me of Okibo. That's Lucky Dubious, You Know Where to Find Me.
I'm not afraid to die.
and then a particular picture I took at Old Love Lock in Imsu.
All right.
On Wednesday, a day after Okibo's death, I was sitting outside and then my classmates were talking about an engineering student that died in football the previous day. And I couldn't even tell them that I knew who the person was. And so I was just sitting down listening to this particular song and then thinking about Okibo. And then, I don't remember if I heard something or I don't remember, but then I looked up, I was under a tree. And so there's this particular, I don't even know how to describe it, I don't know what to call it. But it was the same thing I saw in the movie, Fences.
Yeah.
After Troy's death, and then Troy's brother was blowing the trumpet, and then this, and then when he saw, I don't know how to describe it. But then he was saying, Troy is in heaven. And so when I looked up and saw that same thing, I said, Okibo is in a perfect place. And then I captured it.
So what is the relationship with his parents like? How does he relate with your father? How does he relate with your mother? As the first son of the family?
As the first son, to tell you the truth, when he was in primary school, JS1, JS2, Plainsway was a very stubborn boy. I'll tell you the truth. Yes, he was a very stubborn
How
boy.
How stubborn? Give us instances.
Like, whenever he's at home, I don't feel comfortable.
Wow!
He's always beating me up.
As a first son.
And I would like to obey him. So he always beat me up. He always fights. He always beat me up. But I always make mouth. Shout. He beat me. I run aside. Call my cousins. They will come. Calm him down. Then when they go out there, we continue. So then, I wasn't feeling comfortable whenever he's at home. But many things changed about him. Like, he became a cool guy. He doesn't beat me up again. Rather, he corrects me in a brotherly manner. Then I can remember one Christmas, I was going with him to watch match, the village league, at the community field.
Okay.
So I was going with him on our way. I had goal! So I was like trying to hess him up,
okay,
to meet up. He drew me back. Told me, let my emotions not control me.
Oh, really?
That I should control myself. I should have control over whatever that is going on me. As I'm running now, I will still meet the goal. I will just, who am I running to see?
Exactly.
So I should calm down. I should not allow things happening around to control me. I should be the one to master myself and master things around me.
And you still remember that incident?
I still remember.
So, are there more early memories of him when you were growing up that you can remember?
Early memories.
Some of the things that he did that you didn't like, or some of the things that he did that amazed you?
Well, then, he likes enjoyment.
Oh, really?
He likes enjoyment. So then, I don't know, he's always on cash then. He's always on cash when he was in JS1.
Where does he get money from?
Well, pocket money. He's always on cash. So whenever he comes back, although he beats me up sometimes, we still walk around, buy granules, buy sweets. Then card drops then was 5. That should be 5, 10 naira. So
card drops.
Yeah, card drops.
Okay.
He buy 5 for me, then buy 5 for himself, walk around. Then we don't forget drinking Otu.
What does that look like?
Well, Otu is the seminary name for Gary. In the seminary, we call it Otu.
Okay.
Yeah. So we don't forget drinking Otu. Otu with milk and granite and cold water, sugar.
And cold water.
Cold water.
And sugar.
A balanced diet.
A balanced diet.
Yes, now.
Carbohydrate, protein, this, that.
You know better.
So, are there dreams he shared with you, like aspirations, things he wants to be, places he wants to go, generally?
Before he left the seminary, well, we didn't discuss more then, but after he left the seminary, when he got admission into Futo, then he always tell me, I'll go to America.
Oh.
I'll go to America.
To do what?
To do what? Maybe to work as an engineer.
Okay.
Then, when I was in SS3, I started seeing him more than a brother. He turned out to be a role model. Like, I started admiring his ways, the way people talked good things about him. I can remember an seminar once we stayed up by like then. He asked me, "Are you the brother to Kibo Prince Way?" I told him yes. He said, "Wow, your brother was a neat seminarian." I said, "Wow, really? Thank God." Then I always admired him, like his self-control. One thing he always hammered on then was that I should have etiquette and manners. I should learn etiquette and manners. I can remember one morning, my uncle put on his radio and was listening to news. He left and Hot FM, they were playing Dorobuchi.
That year.
So I increased the volume.
Of Dorobuchi?
Yes. So I increased the volume. So the man came in, my uncle came in and asked why I increased the volume. I told him I wanted to listen to Dorobuchi. He didn't say anything to me, just looked at me and went inside. Then Prince Wei turned down the volume and told me that these are certain things I need to learn on my own. That no one is expected to teach me such things, that I need to learn them on my own. That I wasn't the person that put on the radio, so why should I increase the volume? The radio doesn't belong to me.
Okay.
Why should I touch it? Then etiquette, okay, when greeting your elders, you bow down to greet them. And he also taught me how to visit people.
Oh, really?
Yes, he taught me how to visit, most especially old folks.
Yeah.
I remember I once followed him to visit Mabel. She's late now.
Okay.
The oldest woman in my late, I say the home, in Mogoma, the oldest woman in Mogoma. Well, she's late now.
So what does he do for them when he visits them?
Visit them, then they will talk. Enjoy a melee bear. In what quality? They will discuss. Then they make sure they will say malak malam. Actually, I pay one night.
Yeah.
One for this. They will say yes. She manage a man. I will go back. Then apart from that, this way. Then I can remember. I once followed him to visit my grandfather's sister in Umuguma too.
Oh, really?
Yes. What's for that there? Well, then he likes walking around. He likes walking around visiting places.
He's back.
Yes, whenever he's back. Then, okay, I can remember in 2011, after my primary school, 2011, someone took me out. He had fun.
Took you to where?
He just took me out.
Okay.
On a walk. Yeah, from my house to Moshi. From Moshi, he stopped the bike. He went to Urban Market, then bought some things and came back.
Wow. What a brother.
A big bro.
So apart from having a say in your name, like the children, so are there other decisions that he has reached that affected you in the family? Decisions he has made that has to do with you?
Well, decisions. When he left the seminary, I asked him why he left. He said he doesn't want to be a priest, that he wants to be an engineer. Then, as a photo student, whenever he's at home, or whenever he's at home and the journey is having problem, so I always tease him, engineer, we are learning again of anagenai. He said I should calm down, that I will soon see him in action. He always say, "Boy, I got home on Gamuto."
Mm-hmm.
Then he also has one. Well, how will I put it now? Like say something, okay, equipment. whenever my father has problems, yeah, I'll present it to him. Like, then he'll call me and be showing me things. Well, when I was learning how to drive, he was the first person that started teaching me how to drive. Then, I couldn't continue learning with him because he's always busy then.
Yeah.
So after SS3, I started working at Asunta Place. It was there that I learned how to drive. Well, I couldn't finish my work and meet him back at home.
That was tough.
Very tough. And after my work at the place, coming back, I was having double minds. Okay, coming back to stay in the same room that I used to stay with him. Okay. Seeing his books, his clothes, his shoes.
You're uncomfortable.
I was very uncomfortable. I wanted to stay back, but then I remember mommy was always calling me Eleshi Yoga, Eleshi Yoga. When I decided to come back, it wasn't easy for me staying in that room.
It's not always easy.